Hello everyone, I'm Sergey Temerev from the Russian community of FabrianoInAcquarello participants. Today I'd like to represent to your attention the other lecture related to contemporary Russian watercolor. This lecture's subject will be a bit more narrow and will be special. This lecture will be focused on the St. Petersburg Society of Watercolor Artists. Having the honor to be a member of this society, I was happy to invite persons of my society to collaboration with FabrianoInAcquarello, and I'm happy to see the result. I hope this first step of will become like a milestone point in the long way of common successful actions, especially because of the number of watercolor artists who also members of St. Petersburg Watercolor Society, who repeatedly took part and who continue taking part in the Fabriano exhibitions. And now I'm proud to represent to you the art director of St. Petersburg Society of Watercolor Artists, Natalia Ozerova, and the lecture about society's history, its artists, and the current activities. I hope you will be interested.
I'm Natalia Ozerova. I'm art director of St. Petersburg Society of Watercolor Artists. Some words about our society. Our society has a long, long history since the end of 19th century. And we try to continue the traditions of old society of Russian watercolorists. Of course, we continue traditions, but I hope with new results. The founding of a circle of watercolor artists in 1890 marked the beginning of a notable period in the development of St. Petersburg Watercolor School. 7 years later, the circle was transformed into the Society of Russian Watercolor Painters. According to the statute of the society, its goal was to promote the success and development of watercolor painting in Russia. In 1907, one of the exhibitions took place to celebrate the 25th anniversary of the society. It was a great moment, because by royal order, this society was granted the title imperial to revolt the development of watercolor painting. The first chairman of the society was the academician Albert Benoit, the older brother of Alexandre Benoit. Maybe you know him because he is the author of remarkable, brilliant memoirs about art history, about his life, and he was a very respected person, and a lot of Russian art critics know him, and students, and artists, and so on. First chairman, Albert Benoit, was also a respected person. In his watercolors, he prevailed academic traditions with academic elements, graphics, drawing, and so on. And you'll see his portrait and his watercolors in our movie, you'll see. The total numbers of the society during its history reached about 100 persons. Among them were well-known, famous artists and aspiring artists. It was conception of the society, be together, young and old together. In 1819, after the 38 exhibitions, The society was forced to cease its activity. Why? I hope you know about our great Russian Revolution and what the result. The members of organization were dismissed and its account closed. For a long time, we had no information about this union. It was beginning to be forgotten, but now we have some books, some interesting books, and I can demonstrate you my favorite book, huge book, about Society of Russian Watercolorists, 1880-1918. Maybe this book is not very interesting for artists, because only biographies, only black and white photos are in this book. But for me, it's very interesting. Something about 1996, a project by Nina Dyakova, well-known watercolor painter in St. Petersburg, in Russia, in Mexico, and in the other countries, and art historian Abram Raskin, gave impetus to reviving the tradition of the pre-revolutionary society of Russian watercolor painters. The society really was re-established and registered in 1997. At present, since 2003, the chair of the society is Yuri Shevchik, a member of the St. Petersburg Artist Union. The society numbers over 170 full members, professional artists. The main goal of the creative group in St. Petersburg, according to all traditions and new results, is to unite professional watercolorists in order to preserve the St. Petersburg School of Watercolor Painting, as well as to promote international collaboration in this area. Some words about our activities. Society develops a number of projects, and special projects for us. The most important project is International Watercolor Biennale Art Bridge Watercolor and competition Art Bridge Watercolor. We have now 10 the same events, the same biennales. We organize the exhibitions in St. Petersburg and in other cities of Russia and abroad. We publish catalogs, organize plein air and master classes, and by the way, our master classes are our charitable activities. Artists from Norway, Sweden, Finland, Ukraine, Germany, Brazil, Mexico, Great Britain, China, Kazakhstan, France, and a lot of the other countries usually take part in our projects. And now I would like to notice that 20 years of active life and vigorous activity, large and small projects, publishing catalogs with mosaic pattern cover, depicting the idea of unity, developing international contacts, attracting new members of our society and friends, such enthralling life, of course, can be largely attributed to all members of our society, to those who gave the idea to renew Nina Dyakova and Abram Raskin, and of course of our chief Yuri Shevchik. Thank you for attention, and now I invite you to watch movie about our history and activities, about St. Petersburg watercolors, about those who love watercolors. It's very interesting for me because watercolors, по-русски, водяные краски. Water is вода, and colors is краски. That's why we can make in Russian joke watercolors and watercolors. Thank you very much, and now movie.
Thank you. Thank you.
Dear friends, I hope you were interested in getting to know about St. Petersburg Society of Watercolors and the members and exhibitions. And now I invite you to watch an animated watercolor, two movies about well-known painters, Vladimir Kolbasov and Yuri Shevchik. The authors of this movie are students of St. Petersburg Institute of Cinema and Television, and have a good time.
Вода начинает жить. Вода проходит несколько стадий жизни. Вот она сейчас живая, подвижная, она живет. Она переливается, начинается смешение цвета, является волшебством. Thank you.
Thank you.